Toll to drive up Mount Washington, $29. Brake pad replacement after driving down Mount Washington, $165. Standing on top of the tallest mountain in the northeastern USA, priceless. I woke up this morning in Maine, and while eating my breakfast, I thought, I think I want to drive somewhere else. I think I'm done with Maine. Then after a few more minutes of thought, I realized that I don't recall ever being in Vermont. So I finished up my coffee and we started driving toward Vermont. On the way to Vermont, as we were passing through New Hampshire, I saw a sign that said, Road to Mount Washington. Well, I had to take that road, so off we went. Now, I didn't even mind the expensive toll because my mind was already made up. My only concern was Yaz. She's a tiny four-cylinder, and she now has almost 102,000 miles on her. Ain't no mountain high, ain't no valley low, ain't no river wide enough, baby. If you need me, call me, no matter where you are, no matter how far. They give you an audio CD to listen to as you drive up the mountain with facts such as the same family-owned business that collected my $29 is the same family-owned business that finished building the mountain road back in 1859 when tourists enjoyed the ride up in a horse-drawn wagon. But I had trouble paying attention to the CD because I was busy trying not to drive off any cliffs. There were a few people over the years that have actually died that way. Here, this Volkswagen in front of me kept stopping, even though cars going up had the right of way. I was concerned I would lose traction, like when you drive in the snow. It was a dirt road at this point. But we made it to the top just fine. The only problem was storm clouds were obstructing the view. But they were moving so fast, I figured we could wait a while for things to clear up. A world record wind speed was recorded on this mountain at 231 miles per hour, and it did clear up in a few minutes, and the views were spectacular. Today, I set you free. I told you you could always count on me, darling. From that day on, I made a vow. I'll be there when you want me, some way, somehow. 'Cause baby, you did it, Yaz. You're a champ. Now get us down this mountain. There were signs on the way down advising drivers to stop and cool down their brakes about every quarter of a mile, because you will have your foot on the brakes for the entire 7-mile descent. Unfortunately, I waited until I was about 4 miles down to cool my brakes. So here I stop and notice the smoke emitting from my overheated brakes. And there was a strong odor as well. Not gonna lie, I freaked out a little bit. But I ended up having my brakes checked the next day, and luckily they were fine. I did not have to pay hundreds for any repairs, but if you do a little Googling, there are people whose brakes were ruined by Mount Washington.